Welcome student to my YouTube channel Bharat Chem Study. Today we are going to study about chapter 2 chemical changes for 9th standard of ICC board. In this video part 3 we are going to study about types of chemical reaction like displacement reaction, double decomposition reaction, definition with example. So let's study with the topic displacement reaction. The reaction in which a more reactive element displaces a less reactive element from its compound to form a new compound is called displacement reaction. For example, zinc when is added to copper sulfate solution, which is blue in color, zinc sulfate is formed and reddish brown copper is formed. Here in this reaction, zinc is above copper in the reactivity series, so zinc is more reactive than copper, hence zinc is able to displace copper from copper sulfate solution. So here is the picture. In the observation, when zinc is added to copper sulfate solution, first the copper sulfate solution was blue, but when zinc is added to it, the chemical reaction continued and slowly the bluish color of the copper sulfate fade and a reddish brown substrate is start forming over the zinc rod. That's a very important observation to be note down. Sometimes the question may arise from the observation. So before we go further with the displacement reaction, first again study the reactivity series that we already studied in our previous classes. The Kallu-Nath ka manager aloo zara feeke pakata hai kyunki mercury silver mehenge hain. Here Kallu represent potassium, Nath sodium, calcium, ka manager magnesium, aloo for aluminium, zara for zinc, feeke for iron, kata for lead, hai for hydrogen, kyunki for copper, mercury for Hg and silver for Ag. Metals which are above in the reactivity series are more reactive and will displace the metal present below it from its compound. So see from this figure that zinc is present above copper in the reactivity series. So therefore we can say the zinc is more reactive than copper. That's why in the previous reaction zinc displaced copper from its salt solution. But copper is less reactive than zinc, hence copper will not able to displace zinc from its salt solution. That is, if we add copper in zinc sulfate solution, no reaction will occur. Because copper is less reactive, it will not able to displace zinc from zinc sulfate solution. So to understand whether the displacement reaction take place or not, the reactivity series is very much important. The reaction will take place only when we add a more reactive metal in a less reactive metal solution. For same example, metals present above hydrogen the reactivity series, that is all these metals above hydrogen, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, all these will displace hydrogen, that is they will form hydrogen gas when they react with water or with dilute acids like HCl and sulfuric acid. Similarly, in case of halogen, this is the decreasing order of reactivity. Which is present is above is more reactive, that is fluorine is more reactive than chlorine, chlorine is more reactive than bromine, and bromine is more reactive than iodine. More example of displacement reaction. Iron when added to copper sulfate will give ferrosulfate plus copper. Iron is above copper in the reactivity series, so iron is more reactive than copper, hence iron will displace copper from its salt solution. And observation is that the blue color copper sulfate changes to green color of ferrosulfate and reddish brown copper will settle down at the bottom. This is the observation of this reaction. Similarly, when zinc reacts with sulfuric acid, it will form zinc sulfate plus hydrogen gas is liberated. Again, because zinc is above hydrogen in the reactivity series, so when reactive metals are added to dilute acid, they will form salt and hydrogen gas. That is, they displace hydrogen gas. Similarly, iron when added to HCl, it will form FeCl2 plus hydrogen gas is produced. Calcium is also reactive than hydrogen. Therefore, when calcium is reacted with water, it forms calcium hydroxide and produces hydrogen gas. In all these reactions, which we have written above, zinc, iron, calcium are above hydrogen in the reactivity series. So, when they react with dilute acid or water, they displace hydrogen from it to form hydrogen gas. Displacement of a non-metal by more reactive non-metal. So, here is an example in which chlorine reacts with potassium iodide. And we have studied in the reactivity set, chlorine is more reactive than iodine. Therefore, chlorine will displace iodine for potassium to form KCl and produce iodine. But in the reaction, copper when added to sulfuric acid, no reaction take place from the reactivity series because copper is below hydrogen in the reactivity series. Therefore, copper is unable to displace hydrogen from dilute acid or water. Therefore, when copper is added to sulfuric acid or HCl or water, no reaction will take place. That must be kept in mind. Now, double decomposition reaction. The reaction in which two compounds in their solution form, it's very important in solution form, react to form new compounds by mutual sharing of their radicals. So, in double decomposition reaction, both the reactants just exchange their radicals with each other and it is called double decomposition or double displacement reaction. For example, see the equation, A, general reaction, AB will react with CD because here in the AB, A is positive radical, B is negative radical and CD, C is positive radical and D is negative radical. So during double decomposition reaction, the acid radical of first compound will get shifted with the basic radical of another compound. So here A gets shifted with the exchange radical. So with A, now D will shift with A and similarly B will shift with C. So this is the example of double decomposition reaction in which both the reactants just exchange their radical. The positive radical of first compound get attached with the negative radical of second compound. Similarly, positive radical of second compound get attached with the negative part of radical of the first compound. So let's study more examples. Double decomposition reaction of two types, first precipitation reaction and neutralization reaction. Let's study the precipitation reaction. The reaction in which two salt solution, always remember solution, react together to give insoluble substance. The insoluble substance are called precipitate and the reaction is called precipitation reaction. For example, NaCl in aqueous solution form when added to silver nitrate in aqueous solution, both are colorless. They exchange their radical sodium combined with NO3 of second compound and Ag get combined with the chlorine of the first compound. So AgCl is formed, which is insoluble in water, therefore it will settle down and form precipitate and NaNO3 remain in the solution. So this is example of precipitation reaction as well as double decomposition reaction. Similarly, when we add sodium sulfate in barium chloride, they exchange their radical to form white precipitate of barium sulfate and NaCl solution is formed. So in both of these reactions, both the reactants are in aqueous solution, that is in solution form, and both the reactants exchange their radical to form the new compound, and these compound insoluble substances are formed. Therefore, it is called precipitation reaction because insoluble substances are formed. And since in both of these reactions, reactant exchange their radical, therefore it is also called double decomposition reaction. Next is neutralization reaction, a reaction in which an acid and a base react to give salt and water is called neutralization reaction. For example, NaH plus HCl, both of these exchange their radical. Na positive go with the Cl negative of the other compound and H positive of another compound will combine with the OH negative of the first compound to form salt, NaCl and water is formed. So here in this reaction, base react with acid to form salt and water, and because both the reactants are just exchanging their radicals, therefore this reaction is called neutralization reaction as well as it is also called double decomposition reaction. Similarly, sulfuric acid when react with calcium hydroxide, it will form calcium sulfate plus water. Again here, both the reactants are exchanging their radical, therefore this is called double decomposition reaction. And also in this reaction, an acid react with the base to form salt and water, therefore it is also called neutralization reaction. So always remember that the precipitation reaction as well as neutralization reaction, both are the example of double decomposition reaction. Always remember, double decomposition reaction take place only when both the reactants are in their solution form. If they are in solid form, no reaction will take place. So learn and note down all the important definition of displacement and double decomposition reaction with examples, chemical equation, and prepare your note. In next video, that is part 4, we will study energy changes in a chemical reaction, that is exothermic and endothermic reaction. Please like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.